Horrid Henry's Early Reader. Horrid Henry's Sports Day. Chapter 1. We all want Sports Day to be a great success tomorrow, announced Miss Battleaxe. I am here to make sure that no one, she glared at Horrid Henry, spoils it. Horrid Henry glared back. Horrid Henry hated Sports Day. Last year, he hadn't won a single event. He dropped his egg in the egg and spoon race, tripped over Rude Ralph in the three-legged race, and collided with Sour Susan in the sack race. Henry's team had even lost the tug of war. Most sickening of all, Perfect Peter had won both his races. If only the school had a sensible day, like TV watching day, or chocolate eating day, or who could guzzle the most crisp day, Horrid Henry would be sure to win every prize. But no, he had to leap and dash about getting hot and bothered in front of stupid parents. When he became king, he'd make teachers run all the races, then behead the winners. King Henry the Horrible grinned happily. Pay attention, Henry, barked Miss Battleaxe. What did I just say? Henry had no idea. Sports Day is canceled, he suggested hopefully. Miss Battleaxe fixed him with her steely eyes. I said no one is to bring any sweets tomorrow. You'll all be given a delicious, refreshing piece of orange. Henry slumped in his chair, scowling. All he could do was hope for rain. Chapter 2. Sports Day dawned bright and sunny. Rats, thought Henry. He could, of course, pretend to be sick, but he tried that last year and Mom hadn't been fooled. The year before that, he'd complained he'd hurt his leg. Unfortunately, Dad then caught him dancing on the table. It was no use. He just had to take part. If only he could win a race. Perfect Peter bounced into his room. Sports Day today, beamed Peter. And I'm responsible for bringing the hard-boiled eggs for the egg and spoon race. Isn't it exciting? No, screeched Henry. Get out of here! But I only... began Peter. Henry leapt at him, roaring. He was a cowboy lassoing a runaway steer. Yeah! Squealed Peter.
Stop being hurried, Henry! Shouted Dad. Or no pocket money this week!
Henry let Peter go.
It's so unfair, he muttered, picking up his clothes from the floor and putting them on. Why did he never win?
Chapter 3. Henry reached under his bed and filled his pockets from the secret sweet tin he kept there. Horrid Henry was a master at eating sweets in school without being detected. At least he could scoff something good while the others were stuck eating dried-up old orange pieces. Then he stomped downstairs. Perfect Peter was busy packing hard-boiled eggs into a carton. Horrid Henry sat down scowling and gobbled his breakfast.
Good luck, boys, said Mom. I'll be there to cheer for you.
Humph, growled Henry.
Thanks, Mom, said Peter. I expect I'll win my egg and spoon race again, but of course it doesn't matter if I don't. It's how you play that counts.
Shut up, Peter, snarled Henry.
Egg and spoon, egg and spoon.
If Henry heard that disgusting phrase once more, he would start frothing at the mouth.
Mom, Henry told me to shut up, wailed Peter. And he attacked me this morning.
Stop being hurried, Henry, said Mom.
Peter, come with me and we'll comb your hair.
I want you to look your best when you win that trophy again.
Henry's blood boiled. He felt like snatching those eggs and hurling them against the wall. Then Henry had a wonderful, spectacular idea. It was so wonderful that Henry heard Mom coming back down the stairs. There was no time to lose crowing about his brilliance. Hurried Henry ran to the fridge, grabbed another egg carton, and swept it for the box of hard-boiled ones on the counter.
"Don't forget your eggs, Peter," said Mom. She handed the carton to Peter, who tucked it safely in his school bag.
"Tee-hee,"
thought hurried Henry.
Chapter 4. Henry's class lined up on the playing fields. Flash! A small figure wearing gleaming white trainers zipped by. It was Aerobic Al, the fastest boy in Henry's class.
"Gotta run, gotta run, gotta run!"
he chanted, gliding into place beside Henry.
"I will, of course, win every event," he announced. "I've been training all year. My dad's got a special place all ready for my trophies."
"Who wants to race anyway?"
sneered horrid Henry, sneaking a yummy gummy fuzzball into his mouth.
"Now teams for the three-legged race,"
barked Miss Battle Axe into her megaphone.
"This is a race showing how well you cooperate and use teamwork with your partner.
Ralph will race with William. Josh will race with Claire."
"Henry,"
she glanced at her list,
"you will race with Margaret."
"No!"
screamed hurried Henry.
"No!"
screamed moody Margaret.
"Yes,"
said Miss Battle Axe.
"But I want to be with Susan," said Margaret.
"No fuzzing," said Miss Battle Axe. "Bert, where's your partner?"
"I dunno," said beefy Bert.
Henry and Margaret stood as far apart as possible while their legs were tied together.
"You'd better do as I say,
Henry,"
hissed Margaret. "I'll decide how we race."
"I will, you mean,"
hissed Henry.
"Ready, steady, go!"
Miss Battle Axe blew her whistle. They were off. Chapter 5. Henry moved to the left. Margaret moved to the right.
"This way, Henry!"
shouted Margaret. She tried to drag him.
"No, this way!"
shouted Henry. He tried to drag her. They lurched wildly left and right, then toppled over.
Crash!
Aerobic Al and Lazy Linda tripped over the screaming Henry and Margaret.
Smash!
Rude Ralph and Weepy William fell over Al and Linda.
Bump!
Dizzy Dave and Beefy Bert collided with Ralph and William.
Wah!
Wailed Weepy William.
"It's all your fault, Margaret!"
shouted Henry, pulling her hair.
"No, yours!"
shouted Margaret, pulling his harder. Miss Battle Axe blew her whistle frantically.
"Stop, stop!"
she ordered.
"Henry, Margaret, what an example to set for the younger ones! Any more nonsense like that and you'll be severely punished! Everyone, get ready for the egg and spoon race!"
This was it, the moment Henry had been waiting for. The children lined up in their teams. Moody Margaret, sour Susan, and anxious Andrew were going first in Henry's class. Henry glanced at Peter. Yes, there he was, smiling proudly, next to Goody Goody Gordon, Spotless Sam, and Tidy Ted. The eggs lay still on their spoons. Hurried Henry held his breath.
"Ready, steady, go!"
shouted Miss Battle Axe. They were off. Chapter 6.
"Go, Peter, go!"
shouted Mom. Peter walked faster,
and faster and faster. He was in the lead. He was pulling away from the field. Then wobble, wobble, splat!
Ah! Yelped Peter.
Moody Margaret's egg wobbled. Splat! Then Susan's. Splat! Then everybody's. Splat, splat, splat!
I've got egg on my shoes! Wailed Margaret. I've ruined my new dress! Shrieked Susan.
I've got egg all over me! Squealed Tidy Ted.
Help!
Squeaked Perfect Peter. Egg dripped down his trousers. Parrot surged forward, screaming and waving handkerchiefs and towels. Rude Ralph and Hurried Henry shrieked with laughter. Miss Battle Axe blew her whistle.
Who brought the eggs?
Asked Miss Battle Axe. Her voice was like ice.
I did, said Perfect Peter, but I brought hard-boiled ones.
Out!
Shouted Miss Battle Axe.
Out of the games!
But,
gasped Perfect Peter.
No buts! Out!
She glared.
Go straight to the head!
Perfect Peter burst into tears and crept away. Hurried Henry could hardly contain himself. This was the best sports day he'd ever been to.
The rest of you stop laughing at once! Parents, get back to your seats! Time for the next race!
Ordered Miss Battle Axe. Chapter 7. All things considered, thought Hurried Henry, lining up with his class, it hadn't been too terrible a day. He loved the egg and spoon race, of course, and he'd had fun pulling the other team into a muddy puddle in the tug of war, knocking over the obstacles in the obstacle race, and crashing into Aerobic Al in the sack race. But oh, to actually win something! There was just one race left before sports day was over. The cross country run, the event Henry hated more than any other. One long, sweaty, exhausting lap round the whole field. Henry heaved his heavy bones to the starting line, his final chance to win. Yet, he knew there was no hope. If he beat Weepy William, he'd be doing well. Suddenly, Henry had a wonderful, spectacular idea. Why had he never thought of this before? Truly, he was a genius. Wasn't there some ancient Greek who'd won a race by throwing down golden apples, which his rival kept stopping to pick up? Couldn't he, Henry, learn something from those old Greeks?
Ready, steady, go!
Shrieked Miss Battle Axe. Off they dashed.
Go, Al, go!
Yelled his father.
Do your best, Henry, said Mom.
Hurried Henry reached into his pocket and hurled some sweets. They thudded to the ground in front of the runners.
Look, sweets!
Shouted Henry. Al checked behind him. He was well in the lead. He paused and scooped up one sweet, and then another. He glanced behind again, then started unwrapping the yummy, gummy fuzzball.
Sweets!
Yelped Greedy Graham. He stopped to pick up as many as he could find, then stuffed them in his mouth.
Yummy!
Screamed Graham.
Sweets? Where?
Chanted the others. Then they stopped to look.
Over there!
Yelled Henry, throwing another handful. The razors paused to pounce on the treats. While the others munch and crunch, Henry made a frantic dash for the lead. He was out in front. Henry's legs moved as they had never moved before, pounding round the field. And there was the finishing line. Thud, thud, thud! Henry glanced back. Oh no! Aerobic Al was catching up. Henry felt in his pocket. He had one giant gobstopper left. He looked round, panting.
Go home and take a nap, Henry,
shouted Al, sticking out his tongue as he raced past. Henry threw down the gobstopper in front of Al. Aerobic Al hesitated, then skidded to a halt and picked it up. He could beat Henry any day, so why not show off a bit? Suddenly, Henry sprinted past. Aerobic Al dashed after him. Harder and harder, faster and faster, Henry ran. He was a bird. He was a plane. He flew across the finishing line.
"The winner is... Henry?" squeaked Miss Battle Axe.
"I've been robbed!" screamed Aerobic Al.
"Hooray!" yelled Henry.
"Wow, what a great day," thought Hurried Henry, proudly carrying home his trophy. Al's dad shouting at Miss Battle Axe. Miss Battle Axe and Mom shouting back. Peter sent off in disgrace. And he, Henry, the big winner.
"I can't think how you got those eggs muddled up," said Mom.
"Me neither," said Perfect Peter, sniffling.
"Never mind, Peter," said Henry brightly. "It's not winning, it's how you play that counts."